Can you solve this geometry challenge? Here's the question. Given a regular hexagon, now what we're going to do is to tilt this a little bit. And then the measure of this segment is 3 centimeters. And this segment measures 5 centimeters. The question is, what is the area of this regular hexagon? Now pause this video right now and see if you can answer this question, because I will show you the answer and the solution in 3, 2, 1. Alright, the answer to this question for the area of this regular hexagon simply equal to 26 times square root of 3 square centimeters. Now the question is, how do we get this result? And here's our solution. So to answer this kind of question, what we're going to do is to consider the area of a regular hexagon given one of its sides. So if we have a regular hexagon, we can split this into 6 equilateral triangles. And now the area of an equilateral triangle can be written as a squared times square root of 3 over 4, wherein a is the length of its side. Now since this hexagon consists of 6 equilateral triangles, therefore, the area of the hexagon is equal to 6 times the area of one of an equilateral triangle. This means that the area of the regular hexagon simply equal to 6 times a squared times square root of 3 over 4. Simplify to 3a squared times square root of 3 all over 2. And this is what we need to answer this question. Alright, in short, we need to find the length of the side of this hexagon, and if we do that, then we're done. So what we're going to do is to let this side of the hexagon be equal to a. Now what we're going to do is to connect this point to this point like this to create a 90 degree angle, and then connect this point to this point to create a triangle. And this triangle, take note, this is 120. In short, half of it is 60 degrees. And the other angle, obviously, is 30 degrees. So we have a 30, 60, 90 right triangle. Now, the opposite side of 30 degrees is A. Therefore, the measure of the side opposite of 60 degrees is simply equal to A times square root of 3. Now, we will use this concept to answer this question. All right. Now, before we begin, let's name some important points. Let's name this point as point A. This will be point B. This is point C. This is point D, and the last is point E. Now, consider this triangle, green triangle, and this brown triangle. Now, what we're going to do here is to call this angle ACB be equal to alpha. Now, this angle BAC, let's call this as beta. Take note that alpha plus beta equals 90 degrees. Now, the whole thing is 180 degrees, of course, a straight angle. We have 90 degrees, we have alpha, therefore the other angle should be equal to beta. And since this is again a right triangle, this angle right over here, or CED, is also alpha. In short, we can say that triangle ABC is similar to triangle CDE. Now, since they are similar, we can say that the ratio of the side BC to AC equals the ratio of the side DE over CE. We know that AC is A, DE is 5, and CE is A times square root of 3. It follows when we cross multiply, we get that the side BC equals 5 over square root of 3. Therefore, the length of this side BC is 5 over square root of 3. From here, we can now solve for the value of A. Let's focus on the triangle ABC, like this. And take note that we can use Pythagorean theorem to solve for the value of a. And if we do that, we get a squared equals 3 squared plus 5 over 3 raised to the power of 2. Now simplify, 3 squared is 9, and 5 over square root of 3 raised to the power of 2 is 25 over 3. Now add 9 to 25 over 3, this will give us 52 over 3. And that is the value of a squared. We don't care to the value of a, but we care to the value of a squared because we have a squared to get the area of this hexagon. Now we will use the value of this a squared to find the value of the area of the hexagon. And here we go. The area of the hexagon can be written as 3 times square root of 3 all over 2 times a squared. And now, we have the value for a squared. This is 52 over 3. Now, simplify. These 3 cancel out. This is just 1. And then, 52 divided by 2, this will give us 26. In short, the area of this regular hexagon simply equal to 26 times square root of 3 square centimeters. And that is our answer to this question. And of course, before we end this video, let's have an extra challenge. And here's the extra challenge. Given this regular hexagon, this length is x centimeters and this length is y centimeters. The question, show that the area of this regular hexagon can be generalized as square root of 3 over 2 multiplied by the quantity 3x squared plus y squared. I will wait your answer in the comment section down below. And as always, we are done.